Welcome to this video lecture series on antenna and wave propagation. In this video lecture, we'll discuss the helical antenna. So for your reference, I have this structure. If I am considering a coaxial cable and if the inner conductor of the coaxial cable is transformed in the form of a helix. So when the inner wire is turned in the form of helix, so helix is this structure. So when the inner wire is turned in the form of this structure, I'll get a helical antenna. So you can see this structure and you can imagine a photograph in your mind that what is a helical antenna. So I'll see this from this structure. If this is my coaxial cable, this is the outer conductor. This green side represents the outer conductor. And this red wire represents, red or blue part represents my inner conductor. So this outer folded out portion is called ground plate. And this structure is called the helical antenna. So what is a helical antenna? Helical antenna is a VHF, very high frequency and ultra high frequency UHF broadband antenna, which is formed by turning the inner conductor of the coaxial cable in the form of a helix. So it is VHF and UHF broadband antenna. Its inner conductor is turned in the form of a helix and outer conductor is folded to form ground plate. So the other information about the structure is that it gives me circular polarization. So now in this structure there are various things. So it is a complex structure and we need to know various things to design this kind of antenna. So these are the various things depending upon which I can design different kinds of helical antenna. So first thing is capital D. Capital D is the diameter of the helix, the set from center to center. So this thing is capital D. Now C is the circumference of helix. So C is equal to 2 pi r. So now I know that diameter is equal to 2r. So C can be equal to pi into d. The next thing is small d. Small d is the diameter of the helix conductor. So this length is small d. Next thing is n. Capital N. Capital N represents the number of turns. The total number of turns in the helical antenna is capital N. The next thing is small l. Small l is the spacing of helix from ground plane. So this is my ground plane and from here my helix starts. So the spacing of helix from the ground plane is small l. Now the next thing is capital A. Capital A is axial length. Axial length is the total length of the antenna. So this length represents A. So it is up to here. Here my antenna stops, so axial length is up to here. So now next thing is length of one turn. Length of one turn is represented by capital L. Capital L is, so this length represents my capital L. So this is my length of one turn and it is called capital L. So next thing is alpha. Alpha is pitch angle. So the pitch angle is, so if I have a perpendicular to the turn and a tangent to the turn, so the angle made in between these two things is alpha, which is called pitch angle. So I have shown a bigger picture of this triangle and it looks like this. So the next thing is capital S. Capital S is the space between two helix. So the space between two helix from here to here. So it represents my capital S. And if I know the space between two helix and total number of turns, so my axial length can be represented as total number of turns multiplied by spacing between the two turns. So now in this diagram, I'll find out what is my pitch angle. So this is a right angle triangle. So applying Pythagoras theorem in this triangle, I can say, so L square is equal to S square plus pi d square. So now if I have to find out L, so now if I have to find out tan of alpha, so from here I can find out alpha. So now, depending upon the alpha, I can classify my helical antenna into various categories. So first case is when alpha is equal to 0. So alpha is equal to 0 means S is equal to 0. So when the spacing between the two turns is 0, so S is equal to 0 means the circular loop antenna of n turns. So it resembles a circular loop antenna of n turns. So the next case is when alpha is equal to 90. When alpha is equal to 90, 10 of 90 would be infinite. So at infinite, S would be infinite. So the condition is, which means the spacing between the two turns is infinite. This can only happen in the case of thin linear antenna. So at the case when alpha is equal to 90, my structure resembles a thin linear antenna. And the next case is when alpha is in between 0 and 90. In this case, my structure resembles a helical antenna. Now I'll see the designing parameters depending upon which I can construct any helical antenna. So if I have to construct any helical antenna, I'll consider various things in my mind. So depending upon those things, I will construct my helical antenna. So first thing is capital D should be equal to 15 ns c square upon lambda cube, where capital D is diameter of the helix, 15 n means number of turns, s means space between two helix, c means the circumference of the helix, lambda wavelength. So r in is equal to 140 c upon lambda, c circumference, lambda wavelength. Axial ratio is equal to 2n plus 1 upon 2n, n represents my number of turns. Half power beam width is equal to 52 upon c upon lambda under root n multiplied by s upon lambda. Similarly, first null beam width is equal to 115 c upon lambda under root n s upon lambda. So now we'll see the modes of radiation. There are two modes of radiation. First is normal mode, second is axial mode. So now if my antenna satisfies these criteria, it is called normal mode. And if it satisfies this criteria, it is called axial mode. So what is normal mode? In normal mode, my radiation should be in perpendicular direction to the plane of antenna. So in axial mode, the radiation pattern should be in the direction of the axis of antenna. So we'll see the designing criteria for normal mode or axial mode. We can design our antenna so as to make it work like normal mode or axial mode. When we require that my antenna should work in the perpendicular direction or the radiation should go in the perpendicular direction to the axis, I'll make it work in the normal mode by applying these conditions, and similarly I'll do it for axial mode as well. So for the normal mode, the condition is the length of the antenna should be very small. So D or NL, NL represents the total length of antenna, which is even less than lambda. So when the total length is much less than lambda, lambda represents the wavelength. So if I am working in very high frequency or UHF, as I said, it is a very high frequency and UHF broadband antenna. So I hope you can imagine lambda is really small. So NL, the total length, is also less than lambda. Similarly, D is also less than lambda. Axial ratio is given by E theta upon E phi, which is equal to 2s lambda upon pi d square. So I'll consider various cases of axial ratio and I'll see for different cases of axial ratio how my antenna would behave. So when axial ratio is 0, it means S is equal to 0. Now in this case, I'll get horizontally polarized wave. Second case is when axial ratio is equal to infinity. When axial ratio is equal to infinity means D is equal to 0. Means denominator should be equal to 0. So in this case, I am getting vertically polarization. Third case is when axial ratio is equal to 1, which means 2s lambda is equal to pi d square. Considering this to be 1, this will go this side. And c, if I consider pi d is equal to c, because c was pi d, so putting c in the place of pi d, so c is equal to under root 2s lambda. So similarly, I can find out d as well. So D is equal to under root 2s lambda upon pi. So now we'll see the conditions for a helical antenna to work as a axial mode. So for axial mode, the condition is C is equal to lambda, the circumference. C represents the circumference, which is equal to lambda, which is wavelength. or the pitch angle should be in between 13 degree to 14 degree, or the ratio of C upon lambda is in between 3 by 4 to 4 by 3. Now we have understood the various conditions on normal mode and axial mode. Now we'll see the radiation pattern of normal mode and axial mode. So this is the normal mode, and if this is the axis of antenna, so my radiation should be in perpendicular direction, so it looks like this. So the upper half and lower half should be equal. I had less space, so I made it like this. Now in axial mode, this is the axis of antenna, so the radiation pattern should be in the direction of axis of antenna, so it looks like this. So now we'll see various merits of the helical antenna. So first is, as I said, it gives me circular polarization, which is important for sky wave propagation. Second is, it has wide bandwidth, simplicity, high directivity, which is necessary for telemetry operations. So third is radio astronomy. So now I'll stop at this point for this video. I hope you understood the various things I talked about the helical antenna. In the next video, I'll discuss another antenna. And if you like this video, share it with your friends and subscribe to this channel for further videos. Thank you so much.